There is no question of Radha and Krishna being two. They don't even have two bodies, two sharir. There's only one supreme Brahma. And that supreme power takes two forms, two rupa. Bandhate becomes two forms. For what reason? Krida, divine pastimes. Again, the scripture says, Radhika Krishna Rupam Cha Krishna Radha Sa Rupaka Sanat Kumar Sangeeta. Radha Rani is the form of Shri Krishna, and Shri Krishna is the form of Radha. Without Radha, there is no Krishna. Without Krishna, there is no Radha. Only formless Brahma. Without Sita, there is no Ram. Without Ram, there is no Sita. Only, dekho Bhagwan ka do roop hai. God has two forms. Dve vav brahmano rupe murtan chayva murtan cha Brihadaranya Upanishad. The Vedas say, God is both good form, Murtan, as well as Amurtan, without form. Some people say God is only formless, Nirakar. No name, no form, no quality, no pastime, nothing. And some say God has form only. Both are wrong. God is both with form as well as without form. But without Shakti, without Radha, without Sita, he has no name, no form, no qualities, no pastime, nothing. Only Brahma, the formless absolute Brahma. When Radha comes into Krishna, Sita comes into Ram, then he has name, form, qualities, pastimes, etc. More than that, to describe who is Radha, the Vedas say, Krishnena aradhyate iti Radha. Rig Vedi Radhika Upanishad. The Rig Veda says that supreme power, supreme Brahma, Shri Krishna, whom Brahma, Vishnu, Shiv, everyone worships, he also worships someone. Shri Krishna worships someone? Yeah, he worships Radha. Krishna aradhyate iti Radha. Bhagavan Krishna himself says in the Brahman Puran, Radhaiva Radhyate Maya. आई वर्शिप ओनली राधा वाई वाई डज श्री कृष्ण वर्शिप राधा रानी अगेन द वेदर्स गिव्स द आंसर आत्मा को राधिका तस्य दिस वेद मंत्र से राधा रानी इज आत्मा द सोल ऑफ श्री कृष्ण आत्मा को राधिका तस्य The dearest thing to us is our own self, soul, atma. No one, nothing is as dear as to us as our own self. For example, two people are walking, girl and boy, husband and wife, and they love, I will die for you, is claiming it. I will die for you, I love you so much. And while they are walking, arms around each other, take a snake, not a real one, Nakili, rubber snake and throw between them. Throw on them. One runs this way, one runs that way. Why? Because the dearest thing to ourselves is our own self. We love ourselves the most. So since Radha Rani is the soul of Shri Krishna, Atma, this is why Shri Krishna, he also worships Radha. Just the gist, a little bit I'm trying to say, people don't understand, they ask sometimes, who is Radha, what is this entity called Radha? Many people don't understand who is Radha. Right? Radha is very special. As a matter of fact, to go to Sri Krishna, only when you chant Radhe Radhe, to make Sri Krishna happy, you chant Radhe Radhe. It is said that when Sri Krishna would go to sleep, he loved Radha Rani so much that then when he would go to sleep, from every pore of his body, Radhe, 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 this song would come. While he was in Dwarka, 16,108 wives, amongst them Rukmini, descendant of Mahalakshmi, Satyabhama, etc. So they were very beautiful. Mahalakshmi is Rukmini. They were so beautiful. And they taught, who is this Radha? That Krishna is always saying, Radhe, 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 Radhe. Some girl, village girl he left, when he left Vrindavan. But he's always, so they have doubt in their mind about who is Radha. So what Sri Krishna pretended to be extremely sick. He, one morning, he got up in the bed and he started to scream with pain. Oh, I'm going to die. My head is hurting me. Oh, my body, oh, I'm going to die. He's acting in this way. But all the queens, they panicked. And they tried everything, but nothing is helping. And they're all crying because Sri Krishna is, for them, this is real, real tears coming from the eye. And he is beating himself on the bed. Oh, too much pain. So Sri Krishna then, in the mind of Naraji, he told Narada to come. Inspired Naraji to come. Naraji. So Naraji came. He saw all the queens panicking and running and crying. These are the wives of Sri Krishna, topmost among saints. Who can be the wife of Sri Krishna? Topmost among saints. So first he did pranam to them, Pai Lage Ma, Pai Lage. What happened? Why are you all so anxious and crying? Oh Naraji, Sri Krishna is dying from pain. His head is splitting. Naraji thought, Sri Krishna? Don't you all know who is Sri Krishna? Are Naraji, we don't understand what you're saying. Naraji said, okay. So he went in the room where Sri Krishna was. He did pranam. He says, Prabhu, kaise? How are you? Sri Krishna says, oh Naraji, my head is bursting open, too much pain, Naraji. अच्छा, जो बीमारी आपने बना है इसकी दवा भी बताइए। टेल द मेडिसिन फॉर दिस सिकनेस यू हैव मेड। अरे नारद क्या बात कर रहे हैं, अरे ठीक है कोई बात नहीं, टेल मी दैट मेडिसिन, वेयर वी गोइंग टू फाइंड दिस मेडिसिन टू क्योर यू। नारद जी, इफ सम भक्त सम डिवोटी वुड टू गिव मी द डस्ट ऑफ हिज फीट चरण धूलि एंड आई पुट इन माय फोरहेड माय हेड एंड क्योर एवरीथिंग विल क्योर ऑल हेडेक आई विल बी क्योर। नारद जी ने सोचा भक्त मैं भी भक्त हूं, आई एम ऑल्सो डिवोटी। नाना भैया इस जगह में नहीं जाऊंगा, एक बार तो बंधन बन गए। वंस आई हैव ऑलरेडी बिकेम अ बंधन इन द ड्रामा होता नॉट गेटिंग इन दिस थिंग ही हैड टू गिव द लॉर्ड ही गिव अ कर्स दैट ही हैड टू कम एज राम। सो नारद जी सेड दीस क्वींस ऑफ श्री कृष्णस वाइफ दे आर द टॉपमोस्ट अमंग से भक्त, लेट मी गो टू देम। So Naraji went and he said, "Oh Ma, dawa mil gaya. We found the medicine. Ah, batao, 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 Naraji. Tell." Naraji said, "If one of you were to give the dust of your lotus feet that Sri Krishna put in his head, he'd be fine." Narad, theek hai dimag. Are you right in the head? A wife give the dust of her feet to her husband. One, she's going to hell, Narak. And second, she's going to get bad name for the whole of history. Narad ji said, yes, that's true. While this talk is going on, Shri Krishna, hey, Narad ji, Narad, maha nahi mili. Narad ji, come here, you're not going to get this deer. Narad ji went, he said, kaha mili, where are you going to get? Jao, bridge. Go to bridge. Vrindavan, the gopis. Gopis, gopiyon ke paas hai. Narad ji went, he disguised himself like an old man. Budhiya banke, aise vesh banaya Narad ji, aur latiya, he took a stick and walking. The gopi saw Narad ji, "Are Narad ji, paila me, paila." Narad ji, "Ji kaise nagri?" They recognize me. Acha, Narad ji forgot his disguise. So they asked Narad ji, "Kahan se aaye?" Narad ji, "Kahan se aaye?" Narad ji said, "I, oh, where you came from? I just came from Dwarka. From my, I just came Sri Krishna ke paas." "Oh, Narad ji, how is Sri Krishna?" So Narad ji said, "Oh, he's having so much pain. His head is bursting." Oh, the gopis are in panic. "Narji, so what is the medicine?" So Narji said, "If one of you, if some of you were to give the dust of your feet to Sri Krishna, he put on his head, he'll be fine." All the gopis put their feet out. Charan ko phaila diya. Hazaron, thousands of gopis. Narji, hakke bakke. Narji is looking. What kind of Narji said, "Do you all people understand what you're doing?" "Are Narji, you have this time lecture dene ki sabko time nahi hai." Or Pran Vallabh, the one who's dearer to us than our life, he's in problem. First go, let him be okay, then come back and then we'll listen to your lecture. Phir kya hoga? Narak jayenge? We'll go to hell. "Are Narji, we have been to hell our power. If we have to go one more time, that our beloved should be okay, we have no problem." Narad ji ne kaha, "Dhanya ho, dhanya. Baliyar, baliyar." Narad ji took the dust of the feet of the gopis, force he drank some, put on himself. Narad ji thought, "I am bhakt, ye hai bhakt. I was thinking what will happen to me there. Oh, sochte nahi, didn't think. Bas, priyatam, only my beloved should be okay. This is called praying, bhakti. That's sukha sukhitvam. To be happy in the happiness of the beloved." Narad bhakti sutra. Narad ji took Then he went to Sri Krishna, he gave Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna just laughed. He was okay, he was already okay anyway. So all the queens are seeing that Sri Krishna is okay, he's off, he's laughing, talking with Narada. So they call Naraji, Narada. Naraji went. Where did you get the medicine? Which devotee gave their charan guli, the dust of their feet? Oh, the gopis. Then the queens, the topmost of saying, Mahalakshmi herself is the queen. They realize the mistake, understand who is Radha Rani and who the gopis are. And why Sri Krishna is always chanting Radhe Radhe. Even while he's asleep, every pore of the body, Radhe Radhe Radhe. So, this is a little bit to tell about who is Radha Rani to take. Many, many days plus, with my small intellect, I'm just given a little bit. So we understand who is Radha Rani. So this is why this line in the bhajan is saying, O Bhaj Shama, O Bhaj Shama. Some people worship Radha Rani, some Sri Krishna, but they're just two forms for the same entity. They're one and the same. Do Prema Rupa Rasadham, they're the very form, personified form of divine love. Although Bhaja Nitakara Brajabham and all the gopis, they worship Radha Krishna all the time. Mama Priya Kama Sundara Shama. Mama Priya Kama Sundara Shama. Chavi Koti Kama.
Sundar Shama.
Some chanting. Oh. is very important, especially in this age we live in. The world as we know it goes in four cycles. Char yuga. First there is Satyug or Krityug, then comes Tretayug, then Dwapar, then the age we live in, it, which is called the Kaliyug, the worst age. The scriptures tell us, Kriteya Dhyayato Vishnu Tretayam Yajato Makhayi Dwapare Parichavyayam Kalav Tadhari Kirtana. Bhagavad Mahapuran, 12th Canto, 3rd chapter, 52nd verse. The Bhagavad says, that which is attained in the age of Satya, with great difficulty, through Dhyana, meditation of Sri Krishna, in the age of Treta Yuga, through Yajna, sacrificial worship to Sri Krishna, in the age of Dwapara, through Puja, ritualistic worship to the Lord, is easily attained in this age of Kali Yuga, just by chanting the name of the Lord. Kale doshani dhera jan nasti eko mahanguna kitana dev krishnasya mukta sangha param raje. Bhagavad Mahapuran, 12th Canto, 3rd chapter, 51st verse. Again the Bhagavad says, even though this age we live in, this Kali Yuga is thought to be the worst age, the storehouse of all ills and evil, it has one redeeming factor not found in the other ages. In this age of Kali Yuga, one can easily become free from the ocean of Maya and attain the ultimate aim of life just by chanting the name of the Lord. The Ramayana Bhale Bhale, there's so many places in the Ramayana. Kali Yuga Keval Hari Guna Gaha Gavat Nar Pavahi Bhavata. Only, Keval means only by chanting the name, the qualities of the Lord, in this age of Kali Yuga, one becomes free from Maya and attains the ultimate aim of life. Kali Yuga Keval Namadhara Sumiri Sumiri Narabhutara Upara. Again, the Ramayana said, just by chanting the name of the Lord, only by chanting the name of the Lord, meditate the name, one becomes free from the ocean of Maya. Besides, we can't do anything else. Ehi Kali Kala Na Sadhana Juja Yoga Na Japa Tapa Vrata Makha Puja. Kadhu Sundaji, to the grace of Bhagavan Sri Ram, has seen uncountable Kali Yuga. Uncountable. And he said to Garudji, the Kali Yuga Mahima of the Ramayana, hey Garud, in this Kali Yuga, these things one cannot do. Hey Kali Kalam Sadhana Juja, Yoga. Yoga means Yam, Niyam, Asan, Pranayam, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi. It's Yoga. One limb is called asana, what people call yoga today in the world. The correct name is yogasana. That's not yoga. Yoga is it impossible in Kali Yuga. Jap, tapasya, austerity, mak, havan, puja, fasting, all we can. Kali Yuga Yoga na jagya jnana ek aadhar ram guna gana. Again, Kadhu Sundaji says to Garuji, in the Kali Yuga, one cannot do yoga, one cannot do yajna, dharma. In Bhagavad Mahapuran, it says, dharma sampadyate shabdhi, ra dharmastu vipadyaya. Bhagavad Mahapuran, 11th Canto, 21st chapter, 15th verse. There are six conditions to fulfill in performing dharma, yajna, all impossible in Kali Yuga. Not going to go deep. here today. Gyan impossible and complete. Churasya dhara nishita duratya kathopanishad. The Vedas say the path of gyan is so difficult, it's like walking on the sharp edge of a sword. Impossible. So just chant the name. Why is chanting God's name so important? Gaurav Mahaprabhu tells us in the Shikshastra. He says, Nama Masadi Bahudha Nija Sarva Shaktis Tartar Titani Amita Smaranena Pala Eta Dishita Vakripa Bhagavan Mamati Durdaiva Mi Vishamiha Janina Anuraga. Shikshastra. In the 15th century, the year was 1486, on the full moon night of the month of Phagun, in the village called Maladweep in India, Bhagwan descended. Radha Krishna became one and descended as Gaurav Mahaprabhu, Lord Chaitanya. He didn't leave much writing. He just wrote 8 Sanskrit verses. It's called Shikshastra. But in this, there's nothing less. Everything we need is in these 8 verses to attain the aim of life. So in this verse of Shikshastra, he says, Hey Shri Krishna, O my Lord, Hey Bhagwan, you have so many names, uncountable. And you're so merciful that you have taken all your powers and put in the name. Nija Sarva Shaktis Bhadya. Now, in other words, you are sitting in the name. God sits in the name. Naam or Nami ne bhed nahi hai. There's no difference between God and the name. Whether his name is Ram, whether it's Krishna, whether it's Shiva, whatever name. God is sitting in the name. And you have made no rules. You have made no rules for taking the name. Which direction to face? Whether it's an auspicious day or not? What kind of clothes to wear? Whether you've taken a bath? How many times you've bathed? Do pranayama? No. No rules. Sit in any direction. Face any direction. East, west, north, south, any. Sit anywhere. In the toilet. In the bath. In the dirtiest place. You didn't pay for a whole month, no problem. Take the name of Bhagwan. We cannot make God impure. He purifies everything. There's a mantra, not Ved mantra, Padma Puran, Puran. But in every ritual in Hinduism, whether it's wedding, shadi, or some auspicious occasion, when a pandit comes to do the puja, the very first mantra he says, he gives the jajman some water in the hand, and then he says, sprinkle. And he says, apavitra apavitro va sarvasthangato piva yas mare kundari kakha samadhyā bhyantara suchi. Apavitra apavitro va, when someone is pure, impure. Sarvastham Gatopiva, wherever you are, whichever situation, you could be the dirtiest place, wherever, whatever situation. Yasmare Pundarikaksha, the one with lotus eyes, the moment you remember Shri Krishna, Shri Ram, Sabahya Bhyantara Suchi, you become pure on the inside as well as outside. Now, where else you make pure? God is a condition for knowing Him. One condition. Bhagwan Shri Ram says to Sugriv, when Vibhishan was kicked out of Lanka by Ravan, he came to the shelter of Prabhu Shri Ram. Everyone seen Vibhishan, He is the brother of Ravan, our enemy. His spy. Lock him up. Throw him in jail. Tie him up. Bhagwan Shri Ram started to laugh. Muskurane. Hey, Sugriv, idhar aa. Sugriv is a general. And he says to Sugriv, Nirmal man jan so mohi paava mohi kapat chhal chhidra na bhaava. Sugriv, only those who are pure heart, pure mind, nirmal man, can come to me, see me, know me, attend me. I cannot tolerate deception, deceit, fraud. If Vibhishan was not pure heart, he could. So God condition is pure heart, and here the mantra says, just remember Shri Krishna, remember Shri Ram, and you become pure inside as well as outside. Bas, why you not hear a puja? Finish. And nobody bothers to tell anybody, meditate on Shri Krishna now, meditate on Ram, chant Ram, Ram, Krishna, Krishna. No, just drink the water. This is not what the mantra says. So you have no rules to take the name anywhere, anyhow. Etadishi tava kripa, Bhagavan Mamati, my Lord, your mercies, your compassion is to the highest limit. But duradaivami vishamiha jannamurataha, my misfortune is also to the highest in that I do not have attachment, love. People take the name, they do jap, all kinds of things. But there's no bliss, no love. It's like some hard work. I've seen people doing jap and they're falling asleep. There's no bliss, no love. Because the belief that God is sitting in the name is not there. That will be vishwas and faith in it. Agar, that if somebody has a faith, 100%, the day that faith, 100%, that God is sitting in the name, 100%, one Ram. You just say Ram once, Krishna once, and you fall on unconsciousness. Behosh. And we are taking 1,000 names, million, uncountable lifetime of God, and nothing has happened. So, this is why God's name is so, chanting the name is so important. You don't have to chant any mantra. There's no mantra which is more powerful than God's name. Because he's sitting in the name. Shankar Bhagwan, he is Swayam Bhagwan. He sits on Mount Kailash. What mantra does Shivji say? Ram. Any name of Bhagavan, but not like a parrot. Tote ki tarah nahi. Smaran. Tulsidas ji ne kaha, Kalyug Sundari ne kaha, Sumiri Sumiri. Kalyug keval naam adhara, Sumiri Sumiri. Nara Uttarahu. Sumiri means Smaran. Sumiran. Smaran. Smaran means to remember, to think. Rup Dhyan. Jagat Guru Tam Kripalu Mahaprabhu, who is only the fifth original Jagat Guru, in topmost, and my Guruji, he puts the most emphasis on Rup Dhyan. Rup means form. Dhyan means meditate. When you take God's name, don't take it like a parrot. Meditate on His form. You are chanting Ram Ram, think about Shri Ram. You are chanting Krishna Krishna, at least think whose name I'm taking. In the world, before we call somebody, we think about it. Oh, call this guy, oh, this lady, call this lady, oh. She came with Woody. Oh, Kathy. So before I even take her name, I'm thinking about her. In the same way, you're going to chant Ram Ram, you're going to chant Shri Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Krishna, Radhe 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 Govind. Think about them first, Vrindavan. Think, meditate. Ab dekho kitna labh milega, how much more benefit you're going to get. So, Rup Dhyan, Smaran, Gauram Mahaprabhu said, Mane Smaran Ram. Meditation, remembering God, is the life of all bhakti. Why? Look, another reason. Who or what is the performer of our action? Karm karne wala kaun? Is it our hand, our feet, our mouth, our ears, our nose? Which one does God know? Which is the performer of the action? The Veda says, the highest authority are the Vedas. The Veda says, Man eva manushyanam karnam bandhamokshayo. Brahm Vidu Upanishad, second mantra. This comes in many other Upanishads also. Narad Pancharatra, Narad Puran, etc. Many places. This mantra comes. What does it say? Man means the mind. Ev alone. Man ev manushyanam, human beings. Karnam is the cause. Bandhan of bondage, moksh, liberation. The mind alone is the cause of bondage as well as liberation. In other words, the mind is the performer of the action. God knows where the mind is. You're doing puja. You're doing puja. Akshat is that time where the mind is? Are you thinking about whose puja I'm doing? Or are you thinking about somebody in the world? Where the mind is? And in sansar mein logo ko bewakoof bana sakte, we can be fool people in the world. We can't fool Bhagavan. Acting kar rahe, acting, reacting that I'm doing puja. 3 hours, 4 hours, and mind all going on. Somebody is doing japa. Hare Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. I have to go and meet Ramesh, I have to go over there, I have to go to the grocery, and he's doing japa. Where the mind is? When I'm saved, when I'm praying to God, when I'm chanting God's name, I'm praying to Him. If I'm thinking about God, then I'm doing bhakti for Bhagavan. But if my mind is in the world, then it just becomes physical dream. So the mind is most important. Because the mind, in the Gita, Bhagavan is given most emphasis on the mind. He's telling Arjuna, the mind, the mind, the mind, focus the mind. The mind, most important. Then Arjuna says, how to do? Chantalam manakrishna pramati balavadhyam tasyam nigahamane vayu vasu dushkaram. Chapter 6, verse 34, Gita. How to control this mind? It is so strong, turbulent, and unyielding. It is more difficult to control the mind than it is to control the wind. Vayu vasu dushkaram. And Shri Krishna agreed. 100%, he said, Asanshaya Mahabaho Mano Durnigraham Chalam. I agree with you, Arjun, 100%. The mind is difficult to control, Durnigraham, but not impossible. How to do it? Abhyasin Bhavanteya Vairagyena Chakrihyate. We have to practice. Constant practice. In chapter 6 of the Gita, Shri Krishna is teaching Arjun how to do dhyana meditation. Us. First he says ekaki. When you do meditation, sit by yourself. Alone, ekaki. In isolation. Sit a certain way, sit with the legs crossed, like how I'm sitting. Palki marki. You don't have to be full lotus. But this is the best position when you're doing dhyana. Meditation. There are reasons for this. So there's a Brahma Sutra also. Asina Sambhava. When you're going to do meditation, dhyana, sit with the leg crossed. Asina Sambhava. Number one. Second Brahma Sutra, Achala Tocha Peksham. be alert, keep the body in a straight line, keep the back straight. Be alert. The mind is very chanchal. Any type of slackness or looseness in the posture will cause it to wander. And the third mantra, dhyana aksha, brahma sutra, meditate. Dhyana means meditate. Meditate on God, His qualities, His virtues. Don't just take the name like a parrot. Alright? So then we'll benefit more. Chant all the time. Chanting is very important. Chanting God's name. But with the faith, two things. Number one, that God is sitting in the name. Don't just take it like that. Have the faith that God is in the name, that is one. And number two, think about God. Try to meditate on the form. If you haven't practiced in any way, so get some picture. There are thousands, millions of pictures. One you like this one. And then look at it, open your eyes and look, then close the eye and try to visualize what you have seen. In the beginning, you will find that the length of time it takes for you to look at the picture, and when you close your eyes, it will vanish quickly, the vision. Don't worry, open your eyes and look again. If we keep doing like that, eventually the length of time it takes for us to look at the picture or murti will get smaller and smaller. And the length of time when we close our eyes and try to visualize, we get bigger until the point will come, you don't need any multi or picture. Alright? But we have to practice, we have never done it in a special way before. Secondly, don't let it be a multi or picture. Make him alive, let him come alive. See the eyes blinking, the hand moving, the feet moving. Include yourself, you have to make a relation, you have to love. Bhagwan cares about one thing. Ram keval prem piyara. He cares only about love, prem. That's all Bhagavan cares about. Whether you're chanting Ram or you all do, everything is wrong and you don't, you have, Bhagavan will take it. Oh, kitna prem se, kitna piyara se. That's why he ate the jutha phal of Shari. He ate the banana peel of Vidurani. And refused to eat chappan bhog. Patram, pushpam, phalam, doyam. What simple things. Leaf, flower, fruit, a few drops of water. But yome bhaktya prayachati. Chapter 9, verse 26, Gita. Give it with love, praise. That my lunga. Then he's going to eat. Otherwise, you can give the best thing in the world. It's not going to take. So that's why the mind. What do you love? This is the most important thing in bhakti. So yes, chanting, especially in this age that we live in, this is the Kali Yuga, is recommended and is the most important thing to do. And secondly, for that to increase, to get the real benefit, Aarana Dhyana, meditate. Think about the Lord when you are taking the name. Whose name I am taking? Meditate, try to meditate on the form and you will see how much more benefit. There's much more. Some other time we'll do a little more chanting. We'll do Arsi.
Thank you. Yeah. Pause it.
Stop it. Yes, please.